stay up late for. They're who you rush home to from work each day, and how we teach our kids about working hard. They're who you plan your weekends around. They're family. That's why you can count on Nutrina from one generation to the next. From our family to yours, with love and nutrition. Nutrina.
I'm Mark Oppel, recapping the livestock trade on this Thursday. Let's take a look at live cattle futures here. First of all, box beef cutout values inching higher. They started today at their highest level since August 29. Packer margins have been weak, and retail sales have been sluggish as well. The cash market, though, fairly active. We see here toward the end of the day, in fact, the week's business pretty well done at these price levels. Looking at feeder cattle at the close, USDA raising beef export projections for 2012, and that would help November and January, as October is soon off the board. There's more attention in those deferred contracts. Take a look at the hog trade here today. Pork demand has been slow as well since Labor Day, really. And again, hog trade looking at a smaller weekend slaughter. And the cash market here is still lower. The wholesale pork trade at its lowest level since September 16th. I'm Mark Oppel, wishing you a profitable day tomorrow.
They're the reason you can't wait to wake up each day, and who you're glad to stay up late for. They're who you rush home to from work each day, and how we teach our kids about working hard. They're who you plan your weekends around. They're family. That's why you can count on Nutrina from one generation to the next. From our family to yours, with love and nutrition. Nutrina.
Welcome to RFD TV Live, an informative and interactive hour featuring topics and products of interest to rural America, with expert guests on hand to answer your questions or discuss your feedback. And now, RFD TV Live.
Been caring for the ones you care for. More than 30 years of research shows that animal health and performance are improved through Alltech Nutrition. Alltech, we care about nutrition naturally.
Good evening. I'm RFD TV News Director Mark Oppold, and that's just a sample of what is in store for you tonight as we welcome Alltech to RFD TV Live. Now, horse owners are aware of Alltech as the title sponsor of the World Equestrian Games held in Kentucky last year, but they are a lot more than that. Tonight, we're pleased to give viewers a glimpse of what Alltech is all about Alltech's important role to livestock producers and their natural nutritional supplements. We'll talk about their work with algae technology. Algae technology important for the feed and fuel of tomorrow. We'll talk about their philosophy of making science and education fun for the next generation. And later in the program, news about a multi-million dollar distillery. You heard me right. Alltech is using their science and technology in brewing beer, and tonight talking about debuting of a new bourbon. Joining me in studio from Alltech, Dr. Mark Lyons, Vice President for Corporate Affairs, and Elizabeth Bagby, who is Alltech's Strategic Partnership Manager. Both of you, it's a pleasure to welcome Alltech to RFD TV.
Thank you, Mark.
It's great to be
good
here.
To have you here. Let's take one of you, one at a time, and learn more about you and introduce you to our audience. Mark, start with you and tell us about yourself and, of course, your position with Alltech.
Yeah, so I've pretty much grown up in the company. My father's the founder, and I've probably held many different positions. In the last 10 years, I've been in the company full-time. I worked mainly in production, different projects. I had the opportunity to live in Mexico, Brazil, a little bit in Eastern Europe, and then the last couple of years, been very active in North America in the sales and marketing, and recently just taken on this vice presidential role.
Very good. And you were talking before going on about all your travels coming to RFD TV. Just things like your travel schedule is full time.
Yeah, we tend to spend a lot of time on the road. You know, as they say, the fishermen must be in the sea, and we have to go out and really get to know our customers, support our customers and producers, and that's where the action is.
Well said. Nice to have you here, Elizabeth. You as well. Tell us about yourself.
Thank you, Mark. Thanks for having us. I have worked with Alltech for 14 years. I have always worked in the marketing department, and marketing at Alltech is pretty unique. It's an area of the business that we take quite seriously and a big part, and I've really enjoyed being a part of it. As I said, I've also worked out of our Irish office and with a lot of our offices around the world, and now my focus is on key accounts. So really, customers is what our business is all about, and I'm able to focus directly on those key customers.
Very good. And customers, that means you, viewers, if you're in dairy business, beef, pork, poultry, equine, of course, as well. As I mentioned, brewing and a new bourbon is all part of our hour coming up here. Let's get started here, Mark. And Alltech was the title sponsor. I think maybe a lot of viewers recognize the name from the World Equestrian Games coming to the U.S. for the first time here last year. Tell us how that all came about.
Yeah, that was an incredible experience. It was the first time that the World Equestrian Games had ever been outside of Europe. And so they came, we would say, naturally to Kentucky, which we call the horse capital of the world. And that came about through the efforts of a number of people to the Kentucky Horse Park, which is a huge place, place that everybody should go and visit.
They have been on RFD TV. You're exactly right. Everybody needs to go visit there.
Yeah, and it's 1,200 acres, and we were able to hold everything on that one site. We had 600,000 people attend the event. It was 16 days. We had all eight disciplines there. And I think it was an extraordinary event. We actually had 60,000 students from Kentucky that were able to come through the support of a lot of our customers who actually gave money to bring these students there and give them that experience. So it was a very, very exciting event, and probably the first time a lot of people did hear the name Alltech.
But it gave you a chance, again, and we're gonna hear this over and over as we talk about the different areas tonight, Mark, is that Alltech sees, it's an opportunity, of course, but it's also kind of a philosophy that just works into what the Alltech company is all about.
Exactly, you know, so much of it was about the passion, excellence, performance of horse sport, and that's a lot of what we're trying to do in our core business. And so we were able to share a lot of the Alltech world about agriculture and really creating a more sustainable and a balanced world. And we did that through actually having a pavilion. We had 4 acres of interactive sites and got the vast majority of the people that came to the event through there. And that was really where we could showcase.
And you will be the sponsor in 2014, but long before that, Elizabeth, we want to invite people to Lexington next month. It's the Alltech National Horse Show.
Yes, and we're very excited about that event, Mark. We really wanted to have a legacy event, and when we learned more about the National Horse Show, this is the oldest indoor horse show in the United States. This is going to be the 128th year. It's going to be in Kentucky for the first time. It used to be held in Madison Square Garden, back when it was easy to get hundreds of horses into Madison Square Garden. Now it's coming to, you know, really the Mecca, the Kentucky Horse Park, and Alltech is really pleased to be the first title sponsor. It's going to be a hunter jumper event, but just like with the Alltech World Equestrian Games, we're going to have entertainment. We're going to have a lot of educational things for the kids. I think it's going to be a great event for the whole family. And that's next month, coming right up, November 2nd through 6th.
November
2nd
through 6th in Lexington.
Yes.
We will talk about that again. Mark, let's kind of get up above 30,000 feet here and take a look at Alltech overall. Give us a broad brush of the company.
Well, we're truly a global company. We sell in 120 countries. We have offices in 70 countries. And I think that's very important to the culture. The people that are in those places are local. We have a philosophy really of hiring local people. They're very connected into those industries. They can connect with the culture there, but then have that one Alltech culture around the world. Everything we do is about improving the health of animals through nutrition. So through doing that, we can improve their performance. We can improve ultimately the safety of our food chain and the quality of the food products that we produce through agriculture.
And really, the real bottom line of that and the basis is that's natural nutritional supplements. We talked a lot about that before going on. Share that with our viewers.
Yeah, so basically everything we do is about improving that health. We utilize natural processes to produce our products. We ultimately, everything we do then is going to improve that performance of those animals. all of our production, we're primary in all of our products. And we also go in and try and help agriculture create brands, create value-added products, and deliver that to the consumer.
Mm-hmm.
Mark, if I may, I think that
Please.
We have sort of a holistic approach. And I think if you look at trends right now in human health, and of course human health trends go into pets. We think of pets, of course, sometimes as our four-legged children. I certainly do.
Absolutely.
Into horses. And then, you know, throughout, we're looking really at a holistic measure. So it's not just about what we're feeding the animal. It's certainly not just about, you know, the injections or, you know, other products that they're getting. It's about how they're managed. It's about how they're marketed to the consumer. It's about what the consumer wants. You know, your network does a great job showing that agriculture is responding to the consumer. And I think it's a message that we really want to bring through, that sort of holistic wellness, I think, is the word that Mark used, and I thought that was excellent.
Yeah, and that began, your father is the founder and president of the company 31 years ago. I mean, it's been the natural method, I guess, that natural path has been very important to your dad.
Yeah, that actually started back in 1985. We came up with something that we called the ACE principle, so that we had to take care of the animal, satisfy the consumer, and care for the environment. And it's really the balance of those three things that we see as fundamental. So it's been a kind of a guiding principle. Back then, that wasn't necessarily something that people were that concerned about, but that's really helped guide us through the 31 years of development.
We should point out to viewers that they're going to ask, I'll just ask you, where can viewers, they want to know where, we're going to get telephone calls later, I'm sure, where can I get this product I'm learning about? I like what I hear. Where can I get it? What would be the answer?
Well, our range of brands and products are available through most feed companies. We would be working, partnering with most of the major feed companies around the world. So they can go to their feed supplier, they can ask, does this contain Alltech products? They can go on our website and find out what those brands are. We do have a product directly that we sell directly to horse owners called LifeHorse. And that's been a very successful product built upon those 31 years of research. All the science and all the work that we do, we've put into that pack, and that's a kind of a one-a-day product that horse owners have really, really enjoyed.
Mm-hmm. And we had the website up that viewers can write down. They can go there, and they can order the product off of your website.
Exactly. So we're trying to really utilize all forms of media, whether it's the website, whether it's social media, or going through our standard channels to the customer, the consumer. That's we're really in all of those channels at this stage.
What would a user see? How would they see a difference if they knew there were Alltech? And maybe either one of you might answer this, but I'll start with you, Mark. What would they see different in their animals after feed with Alltech in part of the supplement?
Well, the first thing we often see is just the condition of the animal. So actually, just looking at the animal, its comfort level, its stress level, its coat. Those types of things tend to improve first. If you're talking about dairy, obviously, or laying hens, you're going to see an impact pretty quickly in production. Where you're talking beef, poultry, pork, turkeys, obviously, it's more about how they grow. But typically, that's where we're going right now, is really putting these holistic programs in place, focusing on growth rates, focusing on health, mortality, those types of things, those parameters that we can measure, which is a very, very important part of the whole program.
We mentioned algae technology at the beginning of our program. We want to talk about that. Another example here of how Alltech, being a leader here in research and development in feed and in the fuel industry as well. I'll start with you. Maybe Elizabeth, you may have something to add. But Mark, your algae technology, found that very fascinating.
Yeah, so that's a really exciting area. We've purchased that facility earlier this year, and it's been operating now for 6 months. Most of our products come from fermentation, so whether that's bacteria, yeast, different fungi where we produce enzymes, and we're also the biggest producer of organic minerals in the world, algae is what we call our fifth technology platform. So we see this going into nutrition, creating new products for health. There's some very powerful antioxidants that can be produced through algae. And also looking at this biofuels area, there's a lot of people coming and talking to us about that and seeing how we could create more renewable fuels. We just found out, I think just this month, we're actually using more of our corn for ethanol than we are for feed. So algae may be a solution for those types of things. Maybe we can create energy from a renewable source like that as well, take a little bit of the pressure off our corn prices.
Yeah, that's what it's all about. It's a partnership all the way along. I think that's what impresses us about Alltech as we've found out and become more familiar with you. It's a partnership all along the way in every facet, really, of agriculture production, livestock, grain production as well. And I think you might have said something earlier today, Elizabeth, that Alltech is about innovation. I like the way you said that as well. Tell us, you know, kind of what you mean as it relates to this, the algae technology in your research and your business model.
So I think it's really interesting, the algae technology, because we didn't, you know, buy this algae facility and then say, this is our algae product. You know, technology is about it being a platform. And I think really within Alltech, when we look at our core areas, you know, we sort of say the four pillars. We have our innovation, we have our application, we have our education and our involvement. And really innovation, when I give a tour of Alltech, I like to start with research because innovation is what we're all based around. You know, without those products and without those new platforms and those new core areas, we don't have that room to grow. And I think as Mark said, you can open The Economist or any of these magazines right now and hear more about algae, and we need to know what is that going to do within our industry.
You mentioned education right there, and I'm going to stay with you and talk about Alltech's, and your philosophy there is that education should be fun. That was the first things that all your people, when they talked to us, said, we want to teach these young people about agriculture, where their food comes, where it's going to come from in the future. But, and your dad was right there, we want it to be fun.
So, you know, education is a way of life at Alltech. And so many times you hear about companies preaching education, but really with us, it starts with the employee. I personally continue to train and develop within Alltech. But then we also look outside. We want to develop the next leaders, not only within the agriculture industry, but also the scientific leaders. So, for example, we have a program on our website, alltech.com. If you go to alltech.com/kidzone, you can actually look at some educational programs. And this is actually for teachers and also for students. It has a game you can play where you're the farmer, you can sell your products, but it also has modules where kids can learn, you know, especially urban kids, can learn more about how, where does their milk come from? You know, it doesn't necessarily come from the supermarket. Additionally, we have our Alltech Young Scientist program. And this program is really to encourage kids to do scientific work in agriculture. We give them scholarships. We bring them to our symposium every year. So again, education moves forward. Additionally, and Mark, maybe you want to speak to this, we market through education. And that's sort of a cliche term, but I think with us it really is true. We want to bring the great minds together and listen to them and provide a forum for them. And I think our Global Dairy and B500 that are coming up are great examples of that in early December. Mark, do you want to address that?
Yeah, please talk about that coming up here in a month or so.
Yeah, so that whole concept is basically focused around the idea that it's not obvious maybe how to use our products. It isn't something that everybody's going to say, that's something I buy or I've always bought.
It's not like an implement company or something. You know, I'm going to use this to grind feed or whatever.
Exactly.
I understand.
So what we like to do is hold these educational forums where people can come in, exchange ideas. Normally, they can teach each other better than anybody can teach them. And, you know, create that environment where they're sharing ideas. We bring in really top-class people from the industry all around the world. And so the Global Dairy 500 started first about 5 years ago. We had 500 farmers from around the world. We then added the beef section, and so we'll end up with 1,000 producers there in Lexington sharing ideas and going back with something that they can take home, and that's really become an excellent program.
And viewers, if you see those websites appearing, write those down. You can go to those and learn more, I guess, as Elizabeth says, if you're a teacher or a parent and want to play some games as well as teach young people where their food comes from. It's a great, great source. So, again, we'll have those on as we move through this hour. RFD TV will be at the FFA convention coming up next week, 30-plus hours, as our viewers know. Alltech, though, as well, knowing where the young people are, and you want to be there, and tell us about that.
Well, FFA, Future Farmers of America, is one of the best agriculture organizations that we have for young people. So 540,000 active members, 2 million alumni, very active alumni. And I'm pleased because the convention is actually next week. The FFA convention is next week. And that is going to stream on the Alltech Ag Network, which is alltechagnetwork.com. And that's live streaming. So from anywhere, you can watch that convention. I think we're really going to have some folks tapped in through your network and also through FFA. And what better organization? I mean, when we talk about passion, you really see the passion in these young people for agriculture and for farming. And I'm really excited that we're going to be a part of that through the Alltech Network.
Absolutely. And Mark, your dad, the founder and president of the company here, and we have Dr. Pierce Lyons at one of your biggest education events here recently. And let's share those thoughts.
But now let's talk about being the game changer.
And let's ask ourselves, what would it take? How do you change? Where do you change? It starts with you. Your image, your attitude, your confidence. Does Ronan have confidence? Absolutely. Your humor, does Ronan have humor? And he pulls you in through his humor. And your dad or mom was in the pool, you took a chance, you jumped straight in because you knew they weren't going to step aside. At least most of the time, they weren't going to step aside. So what would it take to make it happen? I'm going to get personal. I mean, he got personal, so I'll get personal. Game changers. Game changers come to everybody in different ways.
Game changers. There's a game changer for 30 years. Great to see that. And we want to talk more about the educational side, but you had another event that's just passed here, the World Dairy Expo, and Alltech had a big launch there, Elizabeth.
So kind of following on what we were talking about earlier, I wasn't able to attend the World Dairy Expo this year, which is really unfortunate because I need cheese curds and ice cream. But it's okay. They have those products outside of Wisconsin. We launched our holistic dairy program there. And really, again, as we've spoken about earlier, the dairy program is not about supplements. The dairy program is not about the specific way that you feed. It's about management. It's about how you market yourselves. It's about how you run your business and what is the sustainability of your business. You know, sustainability is a buzzword right now in agriculture, mm-hmm, but how sure. are specific farmers and producers going to continue to sustain their business, whether that's through their families or outside? So our dairy program, again, is really about overall health and how do you manage your return on investment. So let's not just look at bringing down our feed costs. Let's look at what are our feed costs and how can we make more, you know, improve our bottom line. That's what the Dairy Advantage program is all about.
Very good. And we're going to, again, open up our telephone lines now. As you viewers know, we'd like to put you in touch with our guests, equine, dairy, pork, poultry. We've talked about a lot of those things. If you have questions and would like to know more, our toll-free lines are open now, 877-731-6733. Again, toll-free 877-731-6733. When we come back, we'll learn about Alltech's efforts to help the people from Haiti build better lives for themselves. Just another example of the people that are with us here this evening. And that's coming up on Rural America's Most Important Network. But here's how you can help.
What if you could buy a cup of coffee and directly affect the lives of 6,700 families? Alltech Cafe Citadel allows you to do just that. January 12, 2010 will forever serve as a strong reminder. That day, an earthquake struck in what was already the Western Hemisphere's poorest country. We are reminded that Haiti's problems and troubles reach far beyond their recent devastation. Beyond short-term relief, Haiti needs hope for long-term sustainable economic growth. Our idea is simple. Build on what Haiti does naturally. Grow coffee.
And this will be the coffee plant that they will go back out to their co-op members, and they will take these things and the next generation of coffee will come through. And of course, what this is all about is sustainability. You know, you have to think every cup you have, the tiny, tiny way, you're doing your thing and you're helping these communities.
Alltech saw a need and formed a 501c3 nonprofit to work with the people of Haiti and develop sustainable growth. Buying Haitian coffee is one of the best ways you can have an immediate impact. Alltech Cafe Citadel has partnered with the oldest cafe co-op in Haiti to bring you quality organic coffee directly from Haitian families. The entire process is fair trade certified to ensure fair treatment and fair prices to the people of Haiti. The profits from the sale of Alltech Cafe Citadel not only go back to the families of Haiti, but go to improve their community. Alltech's team of agriculture and coffee experts work alongside the coffee growers of Haiti to improve the methods and conditions of growing coffee, and this will ensure long-term sustainability. The co-op sits below the great Citadel La Ferrière. This fortress is a symbol of the determination of the Haitian people. After the slave rebellion in 1804, the Haitian people built the Citadel to show the world that their freedom will never be taken again. The Citadel was constructed to resemble the slave boats that brought the people to the island. This imagery is a strong reminder of where they came from and where they are today. Alltech Cafe Citadel is also a symbol of freedom, economic freedom. With each cup of coffee, you give the people of Haiti hope, opportunity, and pride.
In terms of having an impact, I can think of nothing better than to come to this village, refurbish this, and this is really where I believe we can finally say, hey, we made a difference.
Buy a cup of coffee. By doing this one simple thing, you will improve education, cultivate agriculture, and provide jobs to a nation that needs help. As long as we keep drinking coffee, these families will have support for generations to come. That animal health and performance are improved through Alltech Nutrition. Alltech, we care about nutrition naturally.
The Roy Rogers Show. Watch Sunday's episode, Outlaws Town. Sundays at 12:30 p.m., Thursdays at 5:30 p.m., and Saturdays at noon, all times Eastern, only on RFD TV.
The Johnsons, right?
Yeah.
Which house is yours?
The one with the Silverado up front.
So, what do you do?
Well, nice.
And Bingo was his name.
For those who live life for a living, the 2012 Chevy Silverado. From the worksite to the home front, Chevy runs deep.
Would you like to win $1 million plus $5,000 a week for life on November 30th? Yes! Watch for the Publisher's Clearinghouse Sweepstakes or go to PCH.com. Enter, and November 30th, $1 million plus $5,000 a week for life could be yours.
Come to Clearinghouse, baby.
RFD TV Live, as we welcome our friends from Alltech for the first time to our program. And we welcome them back, and a pleasure to have them on with us. Joining me in studio, Dr. Mark Lyons and Elizabeth Bagby. Our telephone number, as you see on the screen there, is toll-free, 877-731-6733. Telephone lines are open. No matter your question might be livestock-related or perhaps their education, if you're a teacher, would like to know more about how you might teach your students and programs they may have that would help you do that. And also the, in fact, we want to start with that coffee. It was a great presentation and message from your father there in Haiti. And maybe share with our viewers how you became involved in that.
Yeah, it's a very touching piece. Mm-hmm. It was right after the earthquake. My father actually traveled down that week right after to Haiti. Again, he's a guy who, for the viewers that know him or have seen him, he doesn't hang around. He sees something and he gets involved, and so he went immediately down there, and he's been down to Haiti a dozen times since.
Wow.
And the first thing we started, of course, was education. We went and we found a school close to the border with Dominican Republic. We have some long partners in Dominican, and they helped us locate this area in Wanamet, Haiti, and we rebuilt a school. That led us into the next project, which was actually partnering with another program we have with the University of Kentucky. We sponsor an opera scholarship, and the first winner of the Alltech University of Kentucky Opera Scholarship traveled to Haiti, and he created a choir. So we had 24 children in what we called Haitian Harmony, and they actually traveled up to sing at the Alltech FEI World Equestrian Games opening ceremonies, and they met Muhammad Ali, and it was an incredible thing. And from there, when he was down there, he heard about this co-op, and there's 6,700 families that work in that co-op, and what we realized was they were getting almost nothing for this coffee. It was great coffee, it was actually organic coffee, and they were hand-picking these plants. So each family might have 20, 30 plants. So Haiti used to be one of the biggest producers of coffee in the world, and so we wanted to bring that back. We created the brand, put the package together, Alltech Café Citadel, the Citadel being the fortress that was built by the Haitians after their independence from France. And so it's a great symbol. Bill Clinton has often talked about the Citadel being such a powerful image of Haiti, so we wanted to use that image and create this product. So the idea is to sell the product, create the marketing, create the avenue for them, and all the proceeds go back to those families in Haiti.
We've had the website, as our viewers have seen, and I hope they've written that down. And so when they go to that website, maybe walk us through quickly what will happen, how do they utilize and take advantage of the opportunity. I'm sure that many will want to participate.
Yeah, so they can actually buy the coffee right there online. It'll be shipped to them, and the proceeds, again, are going back to the people in Haiti. I think it's a really nice thing. We've had a lot of our customers actually make this the coffee in their office and tell the story and be able to share a little bit more about that. So it's been a great...
Again, if you have questions of viewers about how that all took place or how you might be able to help as well, our telephone lines are open to put you in touch with Mark and or Elizabeth. Again, toll-free is 877-731-6733. 877-731-6733. Telephone lines are open. We look forward to hearing from you. And I don't know that on any of our programs we have ever talked about brewing beer or making bourbon, but again, it's a great example for our viewers of how your company, this company, takes that science and technology and spreads out. Elizabeth, maybe give background of how all that took place.
Well, I'm lucky. Mark talks about coffee. I talk about beer. I think maybe I have the better time slot. So Alltech is based on fermentation, and we talked earlier about core technologies, and really our core technology, the first platform that we had was fermentation. Dr. Lyons has his PhD, and really had worked in both the ethanol and the beverage alcohol industry, Dr. Lyons had. So when we used to go around and we would buy fermentation tanks from breweries, and we all thought, oh, we're getting a beer, and we never got a beer. But in 2000, we actually purchased some tanks from the Lexington City Brewery and decided, you know, this would be a great project for us. It's fermentation, it's brewer's yeast, a lot of our core areas. And so we took that passion that we had for it and developed our own beer. It's called Kentucky Ale. We also have our beer Kentucky Light, which is a Kolsch-style beer, although technically light, it also has a lighter and flavor, and a really nice crisp beer, great seller in the summer. And then our flagship, which is Kentucky Bourbon Barrel Ale. Now, we are the beer of bourbon country. You know, we're Kentuckians. We have freshly decanted bourbon barrels, and we leave our Kentucky ale to age in those barrels 6 weeks, okay? We get that nice bourbon flavor, so that little hint of molasses, that vanilla, doubles in alcohol content, be a little bit careful. That product is really beloved in our state and in many states outside. We're currently in 7 states and continue to expand.
Okay, yeah, you just answered the next question. If people are going, well, okay, can I get it? I'm in wherever they might be. 7 states right now.
Yes, and continuing to grow. So we have launched in Boston, where the beer is very popular. We're, of course, in Kentucky, in Ohio, and some of the surrounding states as well. So, again, that's a fantastic product, but it takes 6 weeks to age. We can't rush it. That's the way Mother Nature intended, and, you know, we learn from the best in bourbon country. But we're hoping to continue to expand, and that's really a fun project for us, but also ties into our core technology, which is fermentation.
Absolutely. So. And, again, if you have questions about that, viewers, lines are open at toll-free 877-731-6733. And maybe have a question about if you're traveling to Boston or an area, Ohio perhaps, where you might be able to taste and test the product that Elizabeth talks about. We do have a caller on the line, and Jerry from Nebraska, you're our first caller. Welcome to RFD TV Live, Jerry.
Hey, how you doing?
Just fine. Go ahead.
Hey, I just switched to Alltech products. I wanted to tell you how great they were.
Well, thank you. Maybe give us an example of some of the products that you're familiar with, Jerry.
The ball lotion. Fuck.
I'm not sure where he was from, but thank you for the call, Jerry. Questions or comments that you're traveling literally around the world, Mark, and those are things that make it all worthwhile, I would think.
Yeah, well, we just had an incredible event in China, and with the event, we actually tied in the beer. We had what we call our President's Club. We had 102 presidents and CEOs of our customers to China. About half of them brought their spouses, and we did for another educational event. Very much focused on really on business and how they can develop their businesses. But we actually launched the Bourbon Barrel Ale in China at the same time, and that'll be a very specialty product there, only a limited release. But absolutely, one of the best parts, I think, about the job is that exposure, getting to talk to our customers, traveling around, sharing what you learn in one place in the next place, and trying to continue to help agriculture develop itself, promote itself better, and really ultimately create a better food system.
Mm-hmm. You know, you mentioned that we've talked about the coffee, talked about the beer, of course, and bourbon. Maybe as we lay for our next caller here, other consumer products that our listeners and viewers, rather, can take advantage of.
Yeah, well, I think if hopefully we can get a lot of people to the Alltech National Horse Show, you know, those that saw the World Equestrian Games, hopefully they come in. And if they do come in, the thing I really want them to try is Alltech Angus.
Alltech Angus.
And so this is the best tasting steak around. And it's incredibly tender. We've basically put our best nutrition around this program. And for the last 2.5 years, been developing this slowly. I call it really a how-to project. It's how can you feed an animal for taste? You know, we're always focused on cost, on performance,
sure,
on efficiency, but how can you actually create the best product possible? And so we've actually done this now with our beef brand. That was the thing that we wanted to, that was kind of our flagship. We were able to do this in chickens, turkeys. We're launching a program into the swine industry, pork industry later next year. And so that's a very, very exciting area for us. And so that would really be the thing that, you know, you can throw away your steak knife. It's so tender.
You said your father, just to make a point, eats his steak with a spoon.
With a spoon, yeah. He likes to make that point and show how tender it is.
Again, it's getting started in a localized area, but growing as well. If someone wanted to test Alltech Angus, where would they go?
Well, they can actually, we partnered with a small retailer called Critchfield's in Lexington, and they have a wholesale arm, and they can actually buy the product online. They can also go to 150 restaurants in the Lexington area that have Alltech Angus on the menu. So that's been something that's been growing very quickly. But ultimately, the objective is really to go out to producers and say, you can produce your animals in the same way, and pulling this right through from restaurants all the way back to the farm.
All right, very good. We have another caller on the line, in fact, from Kentucky. Mary, thank you for calling. You're up next.
I have a question for Elizabeth.
Yes.
Will somebody from Alltech come into the school to do the presentation, or do you have to bring the students to Alltech for a presentation?
Mary, I'm so glad that you asked that question, and thank you for your call. Because you're in Central Kentucky, you have a lot of the Alltech people right around you there. But the KidZone program, especially at alltech.com/KidZone, is really designed so that it can be used by the teacher in the classroom without Alltech having to be there to support. For example, it has worksheets that you can print off directly from the website that the students can go through. And then for the teacher, it actually also has the how do you design the lessons? You know, what are some activities that you can do? So I think, you know, the answer to you, certainly in Central Kentucky, is we want to work with you and we want to make sure those kids are exposed to agriculture. But this is really an all-in-one program that you can use, that they can be using anywhere else in the world, and really appreciate your interest in it.
All right, thanks for the call. We have more lines open, and we're going to take our last break here and hopefully talk to you when we come back. Our toll-free number is 877-731-6733, 877-731-6733. When we come back, more of your telephone calls and details of the new positions opening, Alltech's plans for expansion, including the new distillery project, talking about that as well. This is RFD TV Live on Rural America's most important network.
Timeless experience and 3 years of nurturing create the real magic of Kentucky's finest thoroughbreds, like Kentucky Bourbon Barrel Ale. Mellowed for 6 weeks in seasoned oak bourbon barrels to infuse that special aroma and flavor of the bluegrass state for you to savor slowly. Kentucky Bourbon Barrel Ale, the beer of bourbon country. Your horse deserves Life Force. From foal to old friend, from pony to performance, the natural ingredients combined in Life Force help keep them healthy. Life Force helps promote digestive health and enhance the immune system. The science is great. The results are outstanding. Try it for 30 days and see if your horse is noticeably better able to cope with the stresses of competition, reproduction, or just plain old horsing around. Life Force. It's proven, it's natural, and it works.
When you have work to do, turn to the leader in productivity and performance, the Bobcat family of utility products. Maintain, haul, push, tow, and lift. More performance equals more productivity. Bobcat utility products are more durable, more versatile, and more comfortable. The utility products family by Bobcat. One tough animal.
People refer to Jill as that woman with the great smile. I refer to her as that woman with the great gums. As Jill's dentist, I know that her gums are a foundation of a healthy smile. Jill knows that too, so she uses Crest ProHealth Clinical Gum Protection Toothpaste. It helps eliminate plaque at the gum line, helping prevent gingivitis. It's even clinically proven to help reverse it in just 4 weeks. And it protects these other areas dentists check most. Crest ProHealth Clinical Gum Protection. Because healthy smiles are built on healthy gums. Life opens up when you do.
Welcome back to RFD TV Live, our friends from Alltech. Wow, we are learning a lot about the products they make and how they are produced and how one leads to another. And we want to hear from you, questions you might have, no matter if you're in the livestock business. Again, we heard from a teacher, bringing education to your students through a presentation live or through the internet as well. Our telephone lines are open for more of you to join us, 877-731-6733. 877-731-6733. We go back to Kentucky for our next caller. Jonathan, thank you for calling. Welcome to RFD TV Live.
Hey, how are you guys tonight?
Fine, thank you for calling.
Hey, I just wanted to ask you guys, I missed a little bit of the program earlier, so I was wanting to know exactly where are these beers and so forth, are these available in bars, or do you actually have them in retailers, or where can I get them?
Very good.
Yeah, the beer is actually available in a number of different locations. It's been very, very successful. It used to be that it was Alltech people going out and asking for the beer and knowing that they didn't have it. And at some stage, they started to recognize us, and it got a little embarrassing.
Awkward.
But it's been a runaway success. And really, if you go into Kroger's, if you go into any major retailer, if you go into most bars, you're going to see the beer.
And these are in like 6 or 7 states, though. I mean, for Jonathan and other, Jonathan, Kentucky is going to be a lucky one.
Yeah.
It's in Kentucky.
Well, the amazing thing is Ohio has actually surpassed Kentucky in sales. So Ohio, it's been a runaway success, and people, again, that have really enjoyed the Bourbon Barrel Ale.
And so we can't name all the states, but they could. Is there a place on the website they could go, Elizabeth and Jonathan and others, saying, I'd like to taste it? Where could they go?
Absolutely. KentuckyAle.com. You're going to have a list not only of the various states that it's carried in and a lot of the restaurants and bars as well, but also all of our events. You know, we really try to get out there. And once people have sampled our beer, we know that they're going to buy it. So go on KentuckyAle.com and make sure you have a look at where we're going to be next.
KentuckyAle.com. Another one to remember. 877-731-6733. Is our telephone number, and we look forward to hearing from you. Well, we have about less than 15 minutes here before we have to say goodnight, so don't miss out before the hour is over. Jack from Texas, you're up next. Welcome to RFD TV, Jack.
Oh, great. Thank you very much. I have a question about these products being used for medical reasons. You know, are any of them aimed at that, or disease prevention or anything like that?
Absolutely. A lot of what we would do would be disease prevention, but in a different way. You know, normally we're not going in through a vet. We're not going in a pharmaceutical way. We're really trying to improve the health status of the animal, and in so doing, you can avoid illness, avoid prevention. So it's more of a preventative way of going about this. There are certain syndromes that are connected to nutritional defects, nutritional deficiencies, and we've been able to target those very specifically. But I think one of the best ways really is to get in touch with your local Alltech office. You can do that through the website. We actually also have a smartphone app where you can go on and you can actually find your local office. So those are tools to utilize. I really think that a lot of what we try and bring is that support to our producers, and that's probably the best way to go about it.
And you mentioned that, again, a viewer might say, well, I can go to my local feed supplier, and I ask, are you putting Alltech supplements in your feed? Would that be a way to also
absolutely. And some of them are using it really to brand their products, or they're co-branding. They're putting our brands on the back. At the same time, others will be utilizing the products, and we help them create their own brands. A lot of what Elizabeth does is actually help our customers create their own brands, and we help them with their marketing and support them in that way.
And I think something that we kind of follow through on with those customers, and I have this conversation a lot, and that is, how can I provide a product to consumers that they are willing to pay for? You know, whether that's a premium or whether they're just going to buy a healthier piece of beef, and can we do that at cost neutral? You know, can we continue to make money and build our businesses in a different way? And that's really what we want to do at Alltech. We want to talk to you about the way that you manage and the way that you feed and having healthy animals all through the chain. So I hope Jack will get on Alltech.com, and I hope he'll give us a call.
Very good. Thanks for that call. Let's go to Arizona. CJ, thank you for calling. Thanks for holding. You're up next.
Hello.
Hi, CJ.
Hi. Really, really interesting program. This is a lot of fun to watch.
Thank
and
you.
Very educational. Anything for dogs and cats?
Did your dog put you up to that? Go ahead.
CJ, I can hear your four-legged children in the background, as I can always hear mine when I call in. Absolutely, and I think Alltech's products are such a good match on the pet side because of our quality control. You know, we really have that safety, that traceability all the way through the chain. And so, again, just like with the livestock customers are coming in, the lifestyle products, of course, horses and pets, go to your manufacturer, ask if they have Alltech technologies inside. Visit Alltech.com and see what those various technologies are. You know, everything from gastrointestinal health, which is a huge issue in aging pets, to antioxidant status. And that's important for us. That's important for our pets. So absolutely, I hope you'll ask your local retailer about that and go see some of those foods and get feed those dogs some of those foods that have our Alltech technologies inside.
All right. Again, telephone lines are open. A few lines open yet for you to join us here live on RFD TV with our friends from Alltech. Call the number on the screen there and join us here before we have to say goodnight. We talked about the symposium here, Elizabeth. The Alltech Animal Health Symposium is coming up May of next year. Mm-hmm. A lot of things on your calendar, but we want to make sure we don't miss this one.
Absolutely. And symposium is really our flagship event, although obviously last year we had a slightly larger event with the Alltech World Equestrian Games. Nevertheless, it's a nutrition symposium, and we really give a lot of the nutritional data and talk a lot about research. But really, this is a really interesting meeting for all different types. So, for example, this year we're going to have a session specifically about marketing. You know, how is food marketed to consumers? How are consumer trends changing the way that livestock is fed? How is branding changing the way that things are done? There's a food-specific session, and there are also sessions for pets, for equine nutritionists, for beef, and for dairy. And we're all about fun, too. You know, we have a big Monday night party. We call it Kentucky Night. We host that at the Alltech Arena, where the Alltech National Horse Show is going to be. And, you know, we would like to have that networking. We want to make sure that the nutritionists and the producers, people who are coming to this event, are having a chance to interact with each other. You know, from all over the world, these folks are the same. Happily, you don't have to travel all the way across the world, be one of the 2,000 who comes to our symposium. We also have what we call a series of lecture tours. And that is where we take those topics from the symposium and we go all around the world. We go to Africa, we go to Asia, the Pacific area, we go to Europe and Latin America. and bring those topics out and talk to those customers in the area. So again, if you miss us in Kentucky, I hope you won't, but if you miss us in Kentucky, have a look on our alltech.com and look at one of our lecture tours.
But if they wanted to come to Kentucky in May of next year, they would go on the website and they could, you could walk through getting registered for that.
You can register, you can see what some of the topics are going to be, you can look at what's of most interest to you and register online.
Very good. And the website is up again. We'll be giving those to you as often as we can before we have to say goodnight. We mentioned at the break there, Mark, that things are growing every year at Alltech, and obviously with new products coming out, including the beer and bourbon. But you said during our before going on the air, something else, that people at Alltech, you said people at Alltech don't have jobs, they have careers. And you meant that.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that a number of years ago, my father was asked to sum up Alltech in three words, and he said, immediately, I only need two. He said, it's fun and passion. And I think when you have a passion for what you do and a passion for the science, the primacy of science, which really underpins everything we do, and a passion for agriculture, it's no longer a job, it's really a life. That's what we really find with our people. And when we're looking for people, we're not looking for people. You know, right now there's a lot of talk politically about creating jobs. Well, people don't want jobs, they want careers. They want something that's going to be something that they can learn and they can continue to develop. We have people who, they might start in one department and be in two or three others throughout their career in Alltech. We have an individual who's actually, even though we've been in business for 31 years, he's been with us for 31 years. We have a number of other people who've been with us for over 20 years. And so that's quite common in the company, that you see people with a very long tenure, and we celebrate that. We actually give people a 10-year pin when they've reached that milestone. So that's what we're looking for. We're looking for people who want to give back, who want to be part of something exciting.
If you've touched a nerve to someone tonight, you have opportunities, for that person, for any of our viewers.
Yeah, we've actually put a number of things out recently, that there's 20 new jobs, which I was surprised because I actually thought it was more than that. There's a lot of growth going on. We have 18 regional offices in North America. We actually do, on the lecture tour, 25 stops in North America and get out. And a lot of what we do on those stops, we actually talk to people and do a lot of hiring in that time. That's the beginning of January. But we're very actively looking for top people so we can continue to grow our business.
Well, the next question for viewers, we may get a call, but before that, we'll just answer the question, how would they, if they're looking and say, I love this company, I want to learn more, I'd like to be part of it, how would they apply?
So they can actually go through our website, and we have a centralized system where all resumes come in and are reviewed, and we'll get back in touch with them. And a lot of these ads are also on different agricultural websites, agcareers.com, those types of things, where people can go on and gain access, learn a little bit about the jobs that are available.
Right. And I'm sure, Elizabeth, that goes without saying, I think, when people that have, just in this hour, learning about Alltech, you're going to put people with their gifts and talents at a place that they're going to be able to flourish, use those gifts and talents, and not put them in the square peg in the round hole, as they say.
I think that's a great, I like the way that you put that, because I think that we're all about bringing those gifts and talents. And you know, we were started by an entrepreneur. We're a very entrepreneurial culture. So if you want to come in and plug the numbers all day long, and of course we have accountants just like everyone else, but you know, we have really a creative and innovative and entrepreneurial team. So I think, you know, come to one of our educational programs, come to our symposium, to our lecture tour, go on our website and learn more and see what are the gifts and skills that you can bring to us. We're really looking for that next big thing.
Very good. And our telephone number, perhaps this might be an area you have a question, you can call now. Lines are open at 877-731-6733. You've been looking, and for that right spot, Alltech may be the spot for you. 877-731-6733. Again, lines are open. Just a few minutes left for you to join us here on RFD TV Live. We want to talk about their President's Club, rather. I think that's another example, Mark, of where the company just, again, taking expertise from all over and just brainstorming, I guess, among other things.
A lot of that, you know, again, trying to create those networking opportunities for people and looking at where new opportunities lie. You know, we talk an awful lot in Alltech about this idea that when we have challenges, and the Chinese actually have a symbol for crisis, and it's opportunity, it's challenge and opportunity together. And so what we try and see is, you know, in each of those challenges there are opportunities, and that was really the underpinning, I think, of a lot of what we do with the President's Club and a number of other things. We try and get business leaders together to think about things like that. This past week, Dr. Lyons and one of our other vice presidents, Aidan Connolly, were at an event in Ireland. Our family's originally from Ireland, and it was all about brainstorming what the Irish economy should do, and what ideas should come out of that. And both of them were very active in trying to come up with those things. So there's a lot of that we're trying to take a leadership position, I suppose, in promoting growth. I think, you know, we talk about sustainability. That's an important thing, but people want to grow. People want to have something better for their children, and I think that's important that we continue to think that way. This country, I think the best days are still ahead, and I don't think a lot of people are thinking that way, and we need to keep promoting that type of a perspective.
That is great to hear, that we would agree with you at RFD TV that our best days are still ahead, and it's the people that will make the difference. And people like you to join us here, our toll-free number, I'll give it to you one more time for you to join us, maybe a teacher or you're a producer and would like to know more. 877-731-6733. Again, if you're just joining us, our friends from Alltech joining us here this evening, and among other things, talking about a new distillery project and a beer that's available and a new Kentucky bourbon as well. Learn about that and give us a call at that toll-free number to learn more about it. Art, as we wait for this last caller, perhaps one more call to get in here, an arts initiative that was also talked about earlier to share, Elizabeth.
So arts and education have really been a focus for us, and one of the things that I'm really proud of working at Alltech is I really do feel like we have that involvement in the community. You know, Mark talked earlier about our Alltech Cafe Citadel, but it's not just about corporate social responsibility, it's about being involved, and it's about what we can do to make a sustainable difference. The arts are such a different area from science and from what we focused on in the past, and yet with the Alltech Opera competition, with the choir that we talked about and kind of extending some of those things out with our support of the arts in general, I think it's something really unique that we can do, and for me personally, I think it's something that gives us that wider dimension and that I really enjoy.
And we do have time, Mark, to talk about, this was on our kind of a list here, if we had time to talk about it, I thought it was very interesting, using the science and technology from the past. We found out here at RFD TV that when you take a look at the history of a product that many of our viewers may know, Dippin' Dots and Alltech are tied together. No. Yeah, they are.
Yes. Yeah, actually, it was a gentleman working in our labs who together with some of our other colleagues created this product and created this concept, and he was using a technology that we were using for a totally different application and came up with this idea that we could create this ice cream of the future, and it's been a very successful venture. I think they have one of the biggest Facebook pages, I think they're in the top 10 or something like that. So it's been a very successful one, and we've looked at growing that globally and continuing that success.
Very good. Again, viewers, you can learn all about these products and all about Alltech here. This keep uncovering new and exciting things that the company is all about. And again, we'll be giving you those websites as we move to the conclusion of our program. In fact, we are at that time. We want to give each of you ample time to have some final thoughts and leave with viewers that they may be taking with them at our show conclusion. Elizabeth, great to meet you and have you on our program this evening. You're first here with some thoughts you would like to leave with our viewers.
Thank you, Mark. Really, I want to invite everyone again to go to our website, alltech.com, to learn more about the company, and also invite everyone to join us in Kentucky. You know, we have our Alltech National Horse Show. It's the first time it's in Kentucky at the Kentucky Horse Park. It's coming up next month, November 2nd through the 6th, and I really think that is about animals at their peak performance. It's something that we can all enjoy, whether we're equestrian-based or not, and also we can learn more about agriculture, about Kid Zone, and just have a good time, come out and enjoy some of the fun we've been talking about.
And we have time for you to kind of talk about some of the things that will be happening November 2nd through the 6th in Lexington. What would they see if they go there?
So the Alltech Arena, this entire event is contained. It's not the full 1,200 acres that I think we walked during the 2010 games. So we're going to have an educational area. We call it horse play. Everything from jumps to the kids to where they learn a little bit more about horse digestion and what are the nutrients they need. How do they recover? How do they perform? Of course, you also have world-class athletes at this event. I mean, this is an FEI-ranked event, Grand Prix on the Saturday night. Huge prizes. Really animals and humans working together at the peak of their performance. So I think there's going to be something for everyone. Oh, and a little shopping. I have to put that in there for my ladies. Definitely a little shopping that we'll be doing.
Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Dr. Mark Lyons, your closing thoughts for viewers.
Well, I think more than anything, hopefully they can take home that we're really trying to redefine the way we feed animals, the way that our food system works, and trying to provide the best quality products ultimately to the consumer. You know, right now, there's a lot of things changing. Food prices have been going up. People are demanding better quality products. They want to know where those products come from. And I think within Alltech and within the partners that we have, a lot of the tools are there to provide that. So I think that's a big piece. I think the other aspect really is that we're trying to create an environment within our own company and those who we work with that this is more than a job. You know, this is something that really you get out of bed for in the morning, mm-hmm. excited, and you're doing something for more than just a paycheck. And so I think we can help continue to grow that enthusiasm. That's a big part of what we can do.
Great. Thank you for coming. Good to have you here. Welcome
Thank
to
you.
RFD TV.
Yeah,
appreciate
we're
it.
Very pleased to be here.
Again, we've covered a lot of ground here tonight, viewers, but there is a lot more to learn about Alltech, and you can learn more by going to the website we've given you. The main one is alltech.com, alltech.com for all those events and the products that we have mentioned here this evening. Thanks for watching, and again, Alltech comes to RFD TV. I'm Mark Oppold. Good night from rural America's most important network.
Tune in next Thursday, October 20th, for AARP on RFD TV Live, 10 p.m. Eastern, 9 Central Time.
Are you tired of spending hundreds of dollars each month heating your home and water? Well, I have an answer.
It's time to start saving on your heating costs and join the thousands that have chosen to install a Central Boiler outdoor furnace. Central Boiler outdoor wood furnaces provide you with the safest, cleanest, and most efficient way to heat your entire home, garage, and water supply. For more information, log on to centralboiler.com.
They didn't invent fire, just a better way to use it.
Programming on RFD TV is brought to you by AuctionTime.com, your online auction source for farm and construction equipment, trucks, and trailers. Visit AuctionTime.com today. No buyer's fees.
T-Lock Fence System. Safe, strong, durable. The T-Post Corner System that lasts. Order your T-Lock Fence System today. www.tlocksystems.com. 1-800-931-7302.
Take the Fixident 12-Hour Hold Challenge. Fixident Denture Adhesive challenges you to a 12-hour hold test. Thanks to its time-released formula, you apply Fixident once.